In spring and summer, I love to do some more crochet work. And I found this lovely floral stitch and I decided I have to do this in English for you too. So maybe you remember years ago, I published a video with the original jasmine stitch, which is wonderful. One flower near the other, so you only see those jasmine flowers, those puff stitches. This is a lovely stitch too, but it makes a rather thick fabric. And so I was very delighted to find this lighter version of the stitch with mesh in between in an old Japanese crochet stitch book. I tried it here with the yarn Amira from Leng Yarns. This is almost pure cotton and I never felt such fluffy cotton before. It's wonderful. And I will do a tutorial for baby blanket for this yarn. For this video, an ant. Spring is and ants are in my room. This is Amalie. Maybe you already know her. And I can imagine this floral stitch, this jasmine stitch, wonderful, being wonderful for a summer top. And so for this video, I will use another yarn, a pure cotton yarn from Prolana. Its name is Ocean and it has wonderful gradients. Tone in tone. So this color is going from orange to deep pink. Very bright colors. I love them. And I already worked a beautiful crochet jacket with it. You find pictures on Pinterest. I called it Aphrodite. So for this jasmine stitch, I call it jasmine light, I use a hook 2.5 millimeters. For the baby blanket, I use the hook 4 millimeters. And for this stitch, you need a multiple of 15 stitches plus 2. So I will start with a base chain. You see orange at the beginning. I will work a base chain of 60 plus 2 stitches. And I will try not to cut this video so that you can work along with me. So we start with a chain of 60 plus 2, 62 stitches. One, two, three. Very often I start crochet items with a base of single crochets or half double crochets, but in this case it's better to start with just a chain because the flowers form a wavy line and it's better you add a border afterwards, after your work. So now I lost my counting, but anyway, I'm working 62 stitches, a chain of 62 as base. This will be two videos. I show you rows 1 to 3 in the first video and the rows 5 to 8 in the second video. Almost there. So now the two extra stitches, 60 is divisible by 15. Now two extra stitches, because we start with a single crochet. And one single crochet into the second chain from the hook. This is row one. I take it a little closer. Now chain three. First row, very easy, chain three. Oh. Don't split the yarn. Skip two stitches and one single crochet into the third. And so on. Chain three, skip two, one single crochet into the third chain. Chain three, skip two, one single crochet into the third, and so on throughout the row. Chain three, skip two, one single crochet. Chain three, skip two, one single crochet. So very easy. Our first row. Always repeat. Chain three, skip two, one single crochet into the third chain. Chain three, skip two. So this way we will create 15 small arcs. Chain three, skip two, one single crochet into the third chain. Chain three, skip two, one single crochet. Chain three, skip two, one single crochet. Chain three, skip two, one single crochet. A few more times. Chain three, skip two, one single crochet into the third chain. Chain three, skip two, one single crochet. chain 3, skip 2, 1 single crochet, chain 3, skip 2, 1 single crochet, chain 3, skip 2, 1 single crochet, and the last one, chain 3, skip 2, and a single crochet into the very last stitch. This was row 1, and you should have 15 little arcs in this row. We continue with row 2, also very easy, chain 5, and 1 single crochet into the first arc. Chain 3, always repeat, chain 3, 1 single crochet into the next arc. Chain 3, 1 single crochet into the next arc. Chain 3, 1 single crochet into the next arc throughout the row. Chain 3, 1 single crochet into the next arc. Chain 3, 1 single crochet into the next arc, chain 3, 1 single crochet into the next arc, chain 3, and don't split the yarn, and 1 single crochet into the next arc. This is a little boring, but I promise it becomes much more exciting with the next row. Chain 3, 1 single crochet into the next arc. And I experienced, you know, the pattern by heart after a few repeats. Chain 3, 1 single crochet into the next arc. Chain 3, 1 single crochet into the next arc, chain 3. Now, after the last single crochet into the last arc, you chain 2 and work 1 double crochet into the very first stitch, or the very last stitch in this case. Not so much for row 2. We continue with row 3, one one chain one and one single crochet into the very first stitch. Chain three and work one single crochet into the next arc. Chain three. Now for the puff stitch, and we don't finish them at the moment. So into the next three single crochets, we work a three puff stitch each. Watch. Yarn over, insert your hook into the single crochet, pull up the working yarn. This pull up is very important. Now yarn over, insert the needle, pull through the yarn. And a third time, yarn over, insert the hook, hook the yarn, and pull it approximately as high as your digit is high. And now repeat this in the second single crochet. Yarn over, pull the yarn through, yarn over, pull the yarn through, and the third time, yarn over, pull the yarn through. And the next unfinished puff stitch into the third single crochet. Yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through. Now you have three unfinished puff stitches on your needle, and you pull the working yarn through all the stitches on your needle. And this is easier as I thought. I thought this will make problems, but it didn't. Just pull the yarn through all the loops and now chain one. Now we need a fourth petal. And we work chain three and a two puff stitch. So yarn over, insert the needle in the middle of the three puff stitches into the center, pull through the yarn, yarn over, and pull through the yarn two times only. Pull the working thread through all the loops, chain one, and one single crochet into the next arc. Chain three, one single crochet into the next arc, chain three, one single crochet into the next arc, chain three, and again, three unfinished puff stitches for the three petals into the next three single crochets. And the most important thing here with the puff stitches is the height of the loops. If you don't pull them high enough, they will be tiny nubs and not a pretty puff stitch. So maybe this needs a little training. Just pull it as high as almost your thumb is high. No, your finger is wide, not high. So now three unfinished puff stitches, pull through the yarn through all the loops, chain one, and chain three for the fourth petal. And a two puff stitch, a double puff stitch, into the center of those three petals. Yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through. Now finish this one, end with chain one, and one single crochet into the next stitch. Chain three, and one single crochet into the next stitch. Chain three, one single crochet into the next stitch. Chain three, and the next flower, half flower. Yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through, yarn over, pull through, and into the next single crochet, the same, a three puff stitch, and again into the third single crochet, a three puff stitch, an unfinished three puff stitch. And now we finish those three with pulling the yarn through and fixing it with chain one and chain three for the next petal. A two puff stitch into the center of those three petals, pull through and chain one. One single crochet into the next arc. Chain three, one single crochet into the next arc. Chain three, one single crochet into the next arc. Chain three, and the next half flower. Almost finished. So you see those half flowers with four petals each. In the next row, in row fourth, in the next video, I show you how to finish those half flowers. Now again, three unfinished puff stitches into the next three single crochets. And don't forget to pull them long, to pull the loops long enough. And the third one, and pull the yarn through, fix it with chain one, then chain three for the fourth petal, into a two puff stitch into the center of the three petals, finish it, chain one, and one single crochet into the next stitch. Finish the row with chain three, one single crochet into the last stitch. Into the last, actually into the third turning chain from the last row. And chain one for starting the next row. This will be the next video. I will publish the second video tomorrow. Enjoy!